Hey guys, welcome back to electronicsinnovation.com. In this video, we will see how to make ESP32 cam and blynk cap based security system with motion detection. In my previous videos, I have gone through sending emails and telegram alerts whenever the motion is detected. But in those projects, there is no way to capture multiple pictures of the intruder on user basis. We cannot identify specific person if the captured image is under focus or out frame. So, I have decided to add another feature where user can capture multiple pictures of the intruder whenever he wants. So, without wasting time, let's get started.
The PCBs I am gonna use in these videos are ordered from PCBWay.com. PCBWay is the one of the best PCB manufacturers in the current industry. PCBWay is offering services like PCB prototyping, assembly stencil, PCB assembly, flexible PCBs and advanced PCBs. At PCBWay.com, we can get 10 pieces of 2-layered PCBs at just $5 with 24 hours build time. The best part of PCBWay is the instant quote feature. Just enter the PCB size, choose quantity, layers and thickness. That's it. We will get the instant quote. Place the order by clicking on save to cart. That's it. Required components are ESP32 camera, micro SD card, FTDI programmer module, PIR motion sensor, NPN transistor, 1K and 10K resistors. Here is the circuit diagram for ESP32 cam and blynk cap based security system. This is PIR motion sensor. This is an intermediate trigger circuit between motion sensor and ESP32. Here is the ESP32 cam module, which is the heart of the device. This is the FTDI module to program ESP32 module because it doesn't have any onboard programming module. And this connection is required to put ESP32 cam module in boot mode while uploading code. I have implemented the schematic diagram of same circuit on easyeda.com. This is PIR motion sensor, intermediate trigger circuit, ESP32 camera, header to interface with FTDI module. This header to short IO0 and ground pins. This header will help us in selection of 3.3 volts or 5 volts from FTDI module. This header is used to supply the input power either from the battery or 5 volts 1 ampere adapter. Here is the PCB for schematic that we have discussed till now. This is top layer. This is bottom layer. This is the top silk layer where all annotations will be mentioned, and this is bottom silk layer. Here we can see 3D view of the final PCB like this. Let's generate the Gerber file by clicking on this icon. Select Yes, check DRC option. If there is no errors, we will get this pop-up where we can get the dimensions of PCB and download the PCB Gerber file. Yeah, here it is downloaded successfully. Let's order the PCB on PCBWay.com. Enter dimensions of PCB. Choose quantity as 10 pieces. 2 layers and thickness of 1.6 mm is okay for me. So, I move to quote now. Here, we have a lot of options. We have to select them according to our requirement. Mostly, we don't have to change anything. We have to make sure of layers, soldering mask and silk screen. Coming to the pricing and build time, I'll choose 2 to 3 days, which is cheaper one. Coming to the shipping method, there are different services are available like DHL, FedEx, China Post and ePacket. Out of all these, I'll choose DHL because of lesser delivery time. Then save to cart. A pop-up will open to upload the Gerber file. Simply select the Gerber file from the location and upload it. Then submit the order. After that, status of order will shown as subject to audit. At this time, some folks from PCBWay will verify the Gerber file whether it is good to go or any manufacturing difficulties are there. After some time, the status will turn to pass payment. This means our PCB good to go and there is no difficulties. Now you can proceed to payment. Select favorite mode of payment and complete the order. That's it.
1 week later.
It took me 7 days to get my parcel delivered to my lab from PCBWay via DHL courier service. PCBs are nicely packed in the cardboard box as we can see here. Let's unbox it. Here you can see PCBs are neatly packed in the vacuum plastic film packaging. Let's open it. PCBs are so nice. I can feel the softness of the surface of the PCBs. Here you can see the soldering mask and silkscreen of the PCBs are very good at quality. The border finishing added value to the PCBs. Let's start the assembling process of the PCBs. I will solder lowest height components first, which is the standard procedure.
A few moments later.
Soldering work has been done. Let's place the modules on PCB. ESP32. PIR Motion Sensor. And finally, FTDI module. Shorting IO 0 and ground pins. Selecting 5 volt supply. That's it. PCB is ready for uploading code. Before jumping into the programming part, let's set up the Blynk app for our project. Install the Blynk app from the Play Store and open it. Tap on a new project. Enter a name for the project. Choose device type ESP32 dev board. Choose connection type Wi-Fi. Then create it. That's it. The project is successfully created. An authorization code has been sent to registered email. We will use this code while programming ESP32 camera. Now click on OK. This is the project edit page where we can add multiple Blynk widgets to the project by clicking on the plus sign. Since we wanted to display captured image, let's add an image gallery widget here. Then long press the widget to maximize the size. Now tap on the widget to assign virtual pin. Then come back. We wanted to capture the image on the user basis. So let's add a styled button, which is a push button. Then long press the widget and maximize the size. Now tap on the widget to select the digital pin 14 for the button. Then change the label color and text on your wish. Then come back. Add a notification to get notified whenever the intruder detected on the surveillance area. That's it. Blynk app setup for the project is successfully completed. Let's move to the programming part. Here is the code for ESP32 Cam and Blynk app based security system. This code will be available on the project page, which is mentioned in the description below. As we are using ESP32 camera module, we should have the ESP32 add-on installed in our Arduino IDE. I have already installed it. You can install it by clicking on this button. You can follow the above tutorial for more info. These are the libraries we are using. These three libraries are pre-installed. You don't have to install them again. We have to install this Blynk library. We can install this library directly from the Arduino Library Manager itself. Go to the Library Manager and install this library as shown here. To make this code work with recently created Blynk project, we need to provide these details. Enter SSID and password for internet connection. Enter the authorization code that has been sent by Blynk while creating the project. This code will be available on the Blynk registered email. Usually, the code will be available on the primary section. But sometimes, it may be found on the promotion tab. Check on the spam if you didn't find it on the primary and promotion section. Copy this Blynk authorization code and paste it over here. That's it. Now this code is ready to upload to the ESP32 camera module. Connect the FTDI programmer with computer. Check the uploading configurations like board ESP32 rover module, uploading speed, partition scheme should be huge app, otherwise the code will not get compiled. Then select the right port. If everything is okay, upload it. Till then the code gets uploaded, I wanted to let you know one thing about our channel. As you can see here, 95% of people who are watching videos in our channel are not subscribed. If you are new to this channel or you didn't subscribe yet, I request you to subscribe and opt to notifications if and only if you find this video is something informative and useful to you. After successful uploading, open serial monitor. Disconnect IO0 and ground pins and restart the module. On the serial monitor, you can see our ESP32 successfully connected to the programmed Wi-Fi and allocated with the IP address. It has also started web server and streaming server with port 80 and 81 respectively. As soon as the motion detected, GPIO13 gets low. Then ESP32 CAM will send a notification to the Blynk app along with the captured image. We can see the received notification on the mobile phone. If we click on it,
someone has been here.
It will open Blynk app and shows the captured image. We will receive the captured image as long as the intruder's motion is detected.
Someone has been here.
We can also capture multiple pictures of the intruder by clicking on this button as shown here. This is one of the good features I have added in this project if we compare with my previous projects.
Someone has been here.
As I have discussed in my previous video, we can use any 5 volts 1 ampere adapter or 3.7 volts batteries like lithium ion or lithium polymer batteries which can be connected like this.
So that's it for this tutorial. This is how we can make ESP32 CAM and Blynk app based security system which will allow us to make multiple pictures of the intruder. So see you soon on the next interesting project. Bye bye.